Reggie here, your friendly neighborhood bodybuilder and comic book collector, and I want to welcome you to my home. Instead of being inside in the comic book room, I decided to film this introduction outside. I'm actually on a deck overlooking the city back there, and I decided to do this outside because I wanted to speak to protection, specifically comic book protection. When I purchased this house a few months ago, I realized that the homeowner's insurance that I was purchasing wasn't necessarily adequate to provide protection for my collectibles inside. So when we got the house, we knew that we needed earthquake insurance because we live in California. We knew we needed some extra protection for fire because we're in the hills and there is a tendency for the hills in California to catch on fire because it gets really dry up here. So we made sure we had protection for those things. But then we needed to do some research on comic book and collectible protection. And so in this video, I'm going to highlight for you the company that I decided to go with and my rationale for doing so. My hope is that you will find it helpful. So I know what you might be thinking after watching that intro. Some of you out there may be saying that you don't have a collection that is large enough to warrant insurance. Some of you might be saying that you only have a couple of keys and no major grail, so you'll be fine. You don't need insurance. Some might be saying that you don't have the money to buy insurance. I want you to keep an open mind as you watch this video. I want you to keep an open mind and think about it. There are a couple of guys that watch these videos that join my chats on a regular basis that have lost parts or their entire collection, either to theft or to fire or to some other disaster. And I can promise you, each one of those individuals that have lost their collections would readily pay $100 to have every single book back in their collection. I can promise you that. Because the last thing you want is for something to happen that is unexpected and for you to lose your collection that you spent your hard-earned money on. So I know I sound like one of those commercials and I apologize for that. But you know, the thing is that spending a couple of bucks to protect your collection in my mind is a worthwhile thing. And it's been something that has been on my mind off and on over the years, and I've never really done it. But with the way that I've been collecting this last year, I realized that it was something that I had to do, and I wish that I had done it earlier. And I am thankful that nothing bad happened to my collection while I didn't have insurance. But I'll tell you, I slept a lot better as soon as that policy was enacted. So I wanted to record this video to help those of you out there that have never considered it or have thought about it and decided against it. And for those of you that have, it just never occurred to you to do it. So this video is for you guys. So what I want to do over the course of this video is to actually walk through some of the sections of the website of the insurance company that I've chosen to use, highlighting certain things. And then I also want to spend a little bit of time at the end of that talking about my rationale for getting the insurance. My hope is that both parts of this presentation will be helpful to you. So the insurer that I chose to use for my policy is Collectibles Insurance Services, and they can be found at collectinsure.com. After spending some time on the website and reading the different sections down at the bottom of the page, I clicked on Get a Quote. But one thing that you'll notice about this site is that it is very streamlined. This is not Geico. This is not Allstate. This is a specialized service. I've dealt with similar companies like this before when I had a classic car. They're very specialized on what they do, and there's not a lot of bells and whistles with this thing. So you want to click on Get a Quote right there in the middle of the screen. And once you do that, you'll go to a page that allows you to select the type of policy that you want. Whether you're a dealer or a collector, you decide the type of policy that you want. I, of course, selected collector. From there, I went to the quick quote page, and this allowed me to plug in some information to figure out what it would cost me to get a policy. And so the first thing they want to know is the effective date. Next, your name, your email address, your phone number, and then also the zip code where the majority of your collection is located. Next, I deselected the box down at the bottom there where, you know, they're going to do some outbound emails to you. I'm not a fan of spam, so I deselected that checkbox, and then I hit get started. From there, I was able to go to the Your Collections page, where I was able to provide some information on my collection. For me, it was relatively straightforward because I only collect comics, where this insurance company actually provides protection for lots of collection types, from guns to figures to cards to comics, et cetera, et cetera. So it was relatively straightforward for me to complete this, this form. So I selected my collection type. I assigned a value to the collection, and I kind of did this in my head just a little bit based upon the books that I've been buying as of late. And then it wanted to know the safeguards. It wanted to know, you know, whether I had a security system, whether I have cameras, et cetera, et cetera. So I plugged that information in there. And then there's an optional coverage section that you can read more about. If you click the question mark to the right, you can actually get more details to determine if you need some additional coverage there. The next section is really reserved for those people that have gold or platinum coins in their collection. I passed through that section, but I did complete the one where it asks, how did I hear about them? So I selected that one, and then I hit the get an estimate button at the bottom of the screen. From there, I was immediately presented with my premium estimate. And for the sake of this example, I plugged in a value on the previous screen of $10,000, and it determined that a $10,000 comic book policy would cost me $69.70. And that's not bad. That's less than 10% of the overall value of the collection. And this is, again, an annual amount that has to be paid. From there, if you decide to move forward, you can hit the apply for coverage button at the bottom. And on the next set of screens, it is basically a chevron that runs across the top of the screen. You can see it says account, eligibility, location, collection, categories, and then summary. We are not going to go through each one of those chevrons, but you will progress naturally through that as if you were to do this in real time on their website. So I just wanted to highlight a couple of the different features that are on a couple of the chevrons. So the first one is eligibility. And here, what they really want to know is whether, you know, you've been rejected for a policy or whether you've submitted any claims in the last 5 years or so. So if you answer those three questions, you can just hit continue and then move on to the next chevron. But we're going to go ahead and jump to the collection tab. And here you kind of complete some of the same information that you completed on the previous screen. But I guess, you know, if you've decided that your collection is worth more money than you anticipated before, or you want to add some additional detail, this would be the place to do it. So again, here you have your effective date, you have your collection type, you have your value, and then it asks you, you know, about the coins again, and then you have the ability to select some of those additional features if you need them. And then down at the bottom, if you have an additional location or two where your materials may be located, where your collection is located, you can actually insert that information there. And so I think this is great if you have a storage facility, or if you're a dealer and have a physical store, this would be where you would want to plug in that information. And then upon completing this page, you hit continue, and then you proceed to the next section. And here is where, under categories, you assign a percentage of your collection to each one of the categories that you would have selected. So for me, I only have one type of collectible, and that is comics. And so that received 100% of my collection. But if I had coins or guns or some of the other types of collectibles, I would have had to break that down into some kind of percentage on this screen. From there, you then jump to your summary, where you can kind of see some of the information that you would have plugged on the previous screens, and then you're able to actually submit your application for processing. So upon submitting your application for processing, it actually goes to an underwriter or some other people behind the scenes that actually review what you submitted on your form. In my case, they responded to me within 24 hours and actually asked me for some additional clarifying information around the different types of security systems that I have in my house. And then immediately after that, I think within 10 minutes or so, they had underwritten my policy, told me exactly what my premium would be, and of course asked for my money. So I immediately jumped on the phone with them to actually pay my money. I tried to pay it via the website, but as I mentioned, this is kind of a bare bones site. It's not Geico, it's not Allstate, and I actually ran into some technical glitches when I tried to submit the payment via the website. So I ended up picking up the phone, calling these guys, having a conversation with them, and they very quickly processed my Visa card for the full payment for the entire year. So again, I slept very well that night, but the entire process from beginning to end took less than 24 hours because of the underwriting process. But it was probably maybe 15 minutes of my time to do it in its entirety. So it was definitely a fast process from me personally, but then also from their perspective of underwriting it, processing the request, and then ultimately collecting the funds. So generally speaking, it was a very fast process. So I want to highlight just a couple of things that really attracted me to setting up my policy. And if you go to the website Collect Insure, you can actually read some of this information for yourself. But one of the things that the website actually points out is that they do what your homeowner's policy can't do. And I would encourage you to look at your policy closely to see if this is indeed true or not. But on the website, they point out that a homeowner's coverage policy is typically based on the actual cash value of a collection and not on its current market value. So if you pick one of those books behind me that has actually gone up in value, there is a good chance that your homeowner's policy won't recognize that value. And that could be a problem, especially with the way that our market is currently performing. The site also points out that homeowner's policies can have limited or no coverage for valuables like silver, guns, stamps, and other items. So again, I would encourage you to definitely check your policy to see whether this is true or not for your insurance company. So one of the major reasons why I love this policy is that it provides me with total protection. And what I mean by that is that, yes, it protects my books while they're here at my house, but they also protect my books when they're not here. And what I mean by that is if I'm traveling for work and I take some books with me, I'm covered. If I'm out of town and I buy books and I'm coming home and the book gets damaged or stolen or whatever it is, I'm covered. If I go to a con and buy books, I'm covered there as well. If I have a remote storage facility, I'm covered. I don't know if a regular homeowner's policy will provide that level of protection for your collectibles. How many videos have I done where I've actually received books that I've purchased that have been damaged? If that happens, I'm actually protected via this policy. I don't know if you guys have ever tried to recover funds from the United States Postal Service or FedEx or UPS. I've heard that it is not the easiest thing to do, and I think that there's limits in place. But again, this policy will offer some protection in the event of any of those things that I just mentioned. And yes, there are some limits in place, and that's why it's important to read the fine print. But some coverage is better than no coverage, just like a low grade is better than no grade. So as you guys are wrapping up this video, I would encourage you to go over to the website or go to Google, do some research, figure out whether you want to provide yourself with a little bit of peace of mind and a little bit of protection for a couple of bucks. I enjoyed doing this video. I hope that you guys found it informative, and I want to thank you for taking the time to watch it. Take care and have a good one.